Dias, guten Morgen, everyone! It's a pleasant morning to start with new learnings. Today, our group will discuss our assigned task regarding to changing standard equation of a parabola to its general form based on the previous lessons that we had. So, without further ado, let's start!
For letter A, x squared is equal to 2 times x plus 4. Multiply 2 times x plus 4. So our equation now is x squared is equal to 2x plus 8. Then additive inverse the 2x plus 8 to the left side. So it will change its sign. It will become negative. Now our equation will be x squared minus 2x plus 8 is equal to 0. Where A and D is not equal to 0 and the axis of symmetry is vertical.
For the letter B, the given equation is y squared is equal to 1/3 times quantity x minus 4. Since there is a fraction form in the given equation, all we have to do is to first multiply both sides by 3. So y squared times 3 is equal to 3y squared. Then 1/3 times 3, the 3 will be cancelled, so it would be 1 times quantity x minus 4. Then we will have a new equation, which is 3y squared is equal to x minus 4. Since we are solving for the general form of its parabola, the right side should be equal to 0. By doing so, we will transpose x minus 4 to the left side, which would be negative x plus 4 by then. So the general form of y squared is equal to 1/3 quantity x minus 4 is 3y squared minus x plus 4. And this is an example of a by squared plus cx plus dy plus e is equal to 0 general form of a parabola which ax squared term is missing, where the value of b and c are both not equal to 0. So, the axis of symmetry of this is horizontal.
For letter C, we have quantity of y minus 2 squared is equals to 4 quantity of x plus 1. As we can see, the quantity of y minus 2 squared is the square of binomial. We have to expand it, and it will become quantity of y minus 2 times quantity of y minus 2. Then using FOIL method, let's have multiply the first term. Y times y is equals to y squared. Then outer term is y times negative 2 is equals to negative 2y. And then the inner is negative 2 times y is equals to negative 2y. And for the last term, negative 2 times negative 2 is equals to positive 4. And simplify negative 2y minus 2y is equals to negative 4y. So that our perfect square of trinomial is y squared minus 4y plus 4. And for the right side of the equation, we have 4 quantity of x plus 1. We will distribute 4 to the x plus 1. So 4 times x is equals to 4x. And 4 times 1 is equals to 4. So it will be 4x plus 4. Since the right side of the equation should be equal to 0, in general form, we will transpose 4x plus 4 to the left side. And when we transpose it, 4x will become negative 4x and 4 will become negative 4. And now, we have y squared minus 4y plus 4 minus 4x minus 4 is equals to 0. Then simplify the similar terms, resulting y squared minus 4y minus 4x is equals to 0. Since the equation is in by squared plus cx plus ey plus f is equals to 0, our general form of equation of a parabola is y squared minus 4x minus 4y is equals to 0. And the value of b is equals to 1 plus the value of c is not equal to 0. So the axis of symmetry is horizontal.
For the last equation, we have quantity of x plus 4 squared equal quantity of x minus 2 since the right side of the equation should be equal to 0 in general form. First, is we need to expand the first equation. So let's expand the quantity of x plus 4 squared. This become x times x is equal to x squared. And positive 4 times 2 equal to 8 times x, and that is 8x. Positive 4 times positive 4 will result to positive 16 is equal to. And the right side of the equation, we have to copy x minus 2, and we all need to do is transpose the equation. So our new equation x squared plus 8x minus x equal negative 2, negative 16 equal to 0. And we have to arrange it so that we get the answer. X squared plus 8x minus x is 7x equal to negative 2, and negative 16 is equal to positive 18. And the final answer is x squared plus 7x plus 18 equal to 0. If we will look at the equation, we will know that this is an example of general form of parabola, which equation is ax squared plus cx plus dy plus e equals 0, where the value of a, which is 1 plus the value of d, which is not equal to 0. So, the axis of symmetry is vertical.
And that's all for today's lesson, everyone. I hope you had fun learning. Don't forget that you're studying not only to succeed, but also to learn. See you next time!